Hi, folks. Welcome to Walking on the Ween Side, part of It Matters Radio. This is the second of a two-part series on Artworks, a very special program here in Tucson, Arizona. And I hope that you will take advantage of the fact that this wonderful program for neurologically impaired adults is offering their art on exhibition at the University of Arizona Recreation Center. That show starts on December 7th and continues on. The reception is on the 7th, and I'm going to be there. It's taking place from 3 to 7 p.m., and they're going to have a boutique offering some holiday presents. But more importantly, they're sharing their view of the Sonoran Desert through their eyes. And as you can see from this brochure, they have some wonderful art and a wonderful sensibility of the world in which they live. So please join us. Hello, folks. Welcome to this special Walking on the Ween Side, which, of course, you know is part of It Matters Radio. Now, I'm here in doing something very unusual for me. I'm on location, and I'm in a special place for me here in Tucson, Arizona. It's called Artworks, and I'm with the director of Artworks, Yumi Shirai. And Yumi and her staff and the volunteers and their clients slash artists have become very, very dear to me and to my wife, and we wanted you to meet them and to learn about Artworks. So, Yumi, tell us about Artworks, please.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for visiting. I'm very, very excited having this opportunity that having you coming into our community and sharing our experience with our artists and our community members with the Artworks. So we are located in University of Arizona, and we are housed in the Center called Sonoran Center for Excellence and Intellectual and Developmental Disabilities. And we are part of Family and Community Medicine, and we are part of the outreach program for our department. So what we do here is we have art studios and gallery, and artists with intellectual and developmental disability gather together with our staff, with the very experienced artists, and also the educator come together to create a community so we can really learn and express ourselves through art and learn about ourselves and learn about others.
You know, the wonderful thing that you just did was you did all that beautiful introduction.
Yes.
And you never mentioned what makes the people here, your clients, special.
Oh, sorry.
Could you talk a little bit about what makes them special?
Elizabeth, okay. Do you have a Sharpie, please?
That's our artist Abby's talking. You need a Sharpie?
Yeah.
All right.
Well, I don't have my apron.
Okay. So do you mind to go check on Diane, Abby?
Ask one from Diane.
Diane?
Uh-huh.
Where's Diane?
She has one in the pink studio. Perfect. So what is special about our artist? So our artist, from my viewpoint, they are very generous. And they are very free from formalized expectations. So they are very talented in expressing their own vision in art and also sharing that with others. And it's very generous and sincere. So with that, oftentimes, I don't say in the general population, but you know, we don't have this community. Sometimes we trapped with the societal norms and what we're supposed to be doing. And we totally forget ourselves, really what inside of ourselves. And our people are really good at sharing that, expressing it, and cherishing that part. I think that's their talent. And they share that part with our artists as a peer, or our staff member as our artist, and folks come to the university to learn something, want to be some professional, they have some societal expectations and norms and what they want to be, but they sometimes forget the place to reflect on who we are. And our artists are great at reflecting those parts.
And of course, the thing is that the artists have certain disabilities as well. And that the thing I really love is how you and your staff have come to see beyond that. And that's what makes this such a special program. You're seeing beyond what society is saying, and you're seeing individuals and their possibility. And I love that.
And thank you. And they are wonderful, great at enjoying the moment. So oftentimes we really have, you know, forget what we have in the moment because they live in the moment. And personally, it can be the blessing from what they have in the disability. You know, they have intellectual disability. So certain times they do not know the planning kind of process, right? Foreseeing something to come. And they oftentimes really live in the moment and feel the moment and share with the person who are in the moment. I think that they are really great at enjoying what they have, and we oftentimes forget that and appreciate that part.
Now, one of the things, though, that we have to remember is, in addition to that, they're artists, and they really are. And behind me, behind us here, is just one of the mosaics that they have created. Right, each piece of this is some kind of a self-portrait, a self-referential piece that one folks here at Artworks is actually done. And maybe you would like pick one out and talk a little about what it represents. For example, who did this? I don't know if we can get a good shot of it, but I love this.
So they have all the memorables of their own association with the Artworks, okay? Mm-hmm. So all the artists did the faces of their own. And then some of the staff members, student workers, when they graduate, they make some pieces that they are really connected with. So this little cat, or we may have little dogs and ducks there. Yeah, some folks are really connected to their own life when they go through. And then another thing is, you know, having our artist around when the young professional is transitioning through the college, they actually help them to really define who they are.
Yes.
So making those art together with our artists, I think that's how they really help the young professional to be okay with who they are and then also explore what they are really great at. And then they discover their essence of their creativity and who they are.
Yeah, I've had some chance to talk with some of the volunteer students, and I guess some of them are even get some kind of pay for their
right.
And it amazes me how they personally feel they've grown. Yeah, through getting to know the artists and part of this community at Artworks. So you have a staff, you have volunteers, you have clients, and one of the things is this is a big facility. There's a few buildings. How many studios are
there? We have four studios.
Four studios, okay, and it isn't all, obviously, it isn't all of mosaics. There is sculpting, there is printmaking, I think, there's all kinds of
painting, paper mache,
all kinds of, and then, just to top it off, you even have a gallery. Yeah. In fact, my wife was privileged to have a show here, and really loved doing it, partly because, of course, the commission's going to a program we love, but also because the folks here have been so welcoming, so warm, and so supportive, and it's been really just a wonderful experience for us. And, of course, now, I should mention, although we're going to be talking about it more throughout the show, you have a show coming up here at the University of Arizona, but not just at Artworks, you're over in the main campus, the Recreation Center.
Right.
And it's coming up in November
9th.
And then it will be, that's the opening, and then it'll be ongoing there.
Right.
And people can see the artwork of some of your artists, I guess all of them pretty much, and also buy some that work and also some things like mugs and totes.
Right, and I forgot to mention the wonderful part, that their talent. So I tried to promote our program on our own, but it really cannot work that way because we work as a community, mm-hmm. and connecting that person more efficient promoter are the artists themselves, and they can speak of their mind and their arts and their why they love this community,
mm-hmm.
and enthusiastically without explanation. So the audience or the community member get that excitement in them as
yes.
they talk to them. So that's the wonderful part, and I think the opening reception would be the wonderful part that we can share that with the community.
Yes. And of course I've gotten to know some, and we will be doing during the show some interviews of some of the artists here. I do have to tell you, I'm going to sit right up front, and I ordered a couple pieces, I commissioned a couple pieces from one of the artists.
Yes, they are very great promoters.
Yeah. Well, no. I went to her.
Okay, wonderful.
I went to her. She did not try and sell me anything. But they are so enthusiastic. But I really, folks, there is something about the artistic sensibility some of these ladies and gentlemen who are artists here at Artworks that just blows my mind. They are really talented people, and you're going to get to see some of that, but not enough. So please, if you have a chance, if you're in this area, come to the University of Arizona and check out that show, and it'll be up there. I know it begins November 9th.
And it's open for a month.
And we'll stay open for a month. And I'm going to say this now because I really want you to think about it, folks. Let's say you have a couple Christmas presents, like an office Christmas present, or a Hanukkah present, or something like that, Kwanzaa present, whatever it is. If you have a present that you want to give, you don't know what to give a person, stop by and pick up from Artworks a mug or a tote bag, and it makes such a wonderful, meaningful present. And also, if you can't get here, you can find UA Artworks, the University of Arizona, Artworks, UA Artworks on Facebook. And then if you go to the community medicine outreach pages, you can also find their website there.
Yeah.
So, Yumi, thank you so much.
You're welcome. And could I add just a little bit? I hope it's going to edit it. So, this program started in 1994 by a professor and art therapist. Her name is Sister Jean Kerrigan, and she had been my life mentor.
Ah.
So, who started this program? With the vision, and also she had a great partner, Mary P. Holland, and we took their names to name our studios and gallery. And their passion in our folks, and then also the belief in the power of art, created this wonderful community. And I am the one of the example of how our people raised students, young professionals. So I think we are a really nice community to foster the all the talents that we
I totally agree. And thank you for sharing that little bit of history.
Yeah.
Sometimes I get so caught up in the moment myself that I forget this history.
Yeah.
And Yumi, again, thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you very much for asking me part of it. Thank you. Yeah.
So, folks, this is another part of Artworks. This is the memorial garden here, and I am sitting on the wall around it with Elizabeth Vargas. And Elizabeth, you are one of the artistic directors, I guess. from Hot Arts. How did you happen to end up here, this particular program, and what does it mean to you?
So I was going to the University of Arizona for art. I was studying studio art. One of my printmaking teachers, Sheila Pitt, was one of the board members for Sonoran USED next door. And I had expressed to her my interest in being in this field of work with the disability people and art. And she told me that she was a board member, and she told me to come and talk to Yumi. And Yumi, at that moment, was like, finish school and then come back. I volunteered for about 3 months. And then I was hired on as full-time staff. And it worked out perfect because I really enjoy teaching art.
Well, I've watched you working with the artists here, and I know how much you do enjoy doing it.
Yeah. I enjoy teaching art, and it's a job where I'm told every day that I'm loved, and that's, not everybody gets that.
No,
so,
What is your goal when you work with either an individual or the group? What is your goal in both artistically and personally and spiritually? What are the goals that motivate you?
I like bringing out the best in the artist. Their artwork and how they are as individual is the best thing to see come out of their work. When they finish an art piece and they come up to me really excited to show me, or they bring me to the side to show me, look what I did, that is the most rewarding part of it. And so the goal is to bring out the best in each of the artists, on a life skill level and an artistic level.
You know, one of the things I've noticed is you actually occasionally go places to help them with the artists, to help them find new material. Like you recently took them out to the Sonoran, I guess it's the National Forest, not the National Park, the Saguaro. And what struck me was a lot of people, they take their students, art teachers, they'll take their students and they'll take them a place like that and they'll say, okay, this Saguaro, isn't that a beautiful Saguaro? And you get 9 or 10 students, all of whom have drawn exact same Saguaro, often using exactly the same medium, the different degrees of ability. But your students, your artists don't do that. They end up creating. I mean, they're picking different things. They're actually deciding what they're going to paint or draw or however they or reproduce in 3 dimensions or however they're going to do it.
Yeah.
And you and the other members of the staff and the volunteers, you're helping and encouraging that kind of breadth.
Yeah. We're a very individual run program. So what that means is that we consider the person first, what they want, and what their abilities are. And we want to encourage them to feel like they can choose what they want to do. And it creates a good environment and a safe environment where they know, you know, when we take them out to go see something that might be part of an art show, it's like, oh, well, this is important. We're doing, you know, it allows them to understand that it's an important project. And we allow them to create anything they want because, you know, it just makes them more interested in the art they're making. And it does make it tricky though, because that means that you'll have like 5 artists within a studio, but they're all creating something completely different. But at the end, when you see them at the art show, be excited, and when they finish their piece, it's very rewarding for them to have that liberty of, you know, creating what they like.
Now this garden here, this memorial garden, that's a perfect example.
Yeah.
Because each of these buildings represents the loss to one of the artists of somebody significant in their life, a family member, family friend, and somebody who has passed. And they have this space in which to place one of these little houses. It has a very Mexican feel to it, which being here in Tucson, Arizona, makes sense. Anybody who's been to like the Botanical Garden here in town,
yeah.
And the Mexicans, it's a great idea.
Yeah.
And you can see, folks, that each one of these is a very different building. And I don't know, because I'd have to talk to each of the artists. Well, why did you make this shape? Why did you do this? Does it remind you of your home or the person's home? Or I see one over there that looks like it looks like kind of a bus or something.
Yeah. Yeah.
Then there's this wonderful one over here. It's curved. I mean, I absolutely love this one. With the mosaic roof.
Yeah.
There's just such a scope of feeling, and what a wonderful way to remember those who have passed. And I also noticed the cat over there.
Yeah.
And that, of course, Vicky was telling me about the cat that she had made.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously, that being a very dear remembrance for all of the people here in the
Yeah, even the cats. Yeah, and what I like about this, having a program that is individual based is that you could tell in each of these whose house it is and who made it just by its artistic expression, and it celebrates the individual that way. And it celebrates and commemorates the people we love, so, yeah.
You know, that's one of the things I really like about artworks is it is a celebration of individuality. So many programs for people who are disabled, the goal is to squish them into the mold so we can,
yeah.
You know, kind of line them up. And this is a place where people are freed and growing.
Yeah.
And if folks make it to the show, which, would you remind them where and when the show is?
Yeah, so our show is going to be at the U of A Rec Center. It's going to be on Friday, November 9th. I believe that is the 9th. And it is going to be about our Arizona Sonoran Desert is the theme. And we were the first ones to be offered this gallery space at the U of A Rec Center. We feel very honored and very excited to be showing somewhere new and to be given the opportunity to be the first ones to display that.
Now that's going to be the opening. The show is going to be on for a while.
Yes.
And folks, I'm going to say again, these works are for sale. And I know you're also doing something else, I understand. You're going to have some objects for sale as well.
Yeah, so we like to involve our artists and in all the process of our shows. That includes making merchandise and hanging the artwork, framing it. I have a couple gallery workers who are helping with all that, but we are having mugs and totes for sale. Mm-hmm. We're making some merchandise for people who want to help and support our program. And of course, it's just an easier way for people to support, common items like that. People love them. So, and our artists are designing them, which is, always a very big part of any art show. We like to have our artists design, and we vote on which designs get to be on it. So
just to iterate, in here we're going to be mugs and tote bags that will have a design. Design created by one of the artists,
yes.
And then they will be for sale. And I, by the way, Roz, my wife, and I are going to be down on that day.
Mm-hmm.
And I want you to know we were just talking the other day about we need a few small presents for the holidays.
Yeah,
you know, people come by and they give you a gift and you want something to give in exchange. And so, what better I can have a gift, meaningful gift to give a friend, and also support a program I love.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I couldn't think of a better thing, so we're going to definitely get a few items, and we hope you will too, folks, if you happen to be in Tucson. And can people who aren't in Tucson who hear the program and want to be involved, is there some way they can connect? and maybe even order merchandise or see the people?
Yeah, well, so right now we're working on trying to create a platform for online purchases through our website. But we do a really good job of connecting to our general audience and people who are just friends and family of artworks through our website. You'll get a lot of updates on what kind of events we're doing there, but we are very good on Facebook too. On Facebook, you'll get a lot of really fun, cute, uplifting posts, which, you know, in such a terrible, you know, scary time, it's nice to see something good. So follow us on Facebook at UA Artworks. That is a really good way to reach us and get to know what we're doing on a day-to-day basis.
UA.
UA Artworks, yes.
That University of Arizona, don't forget that.
Well, it's UA, actually the UNA Artworks, so.
Now, that's your Facebook, and how about your website?
Our website? You can find us through the Family and Community website, and we are under the Outreach tab, and it's going to be Artworks underneath that tab. So, Family and Community Medicine, University of Arizona. You can find us through there.
Okay, great. I love this little garden, and I love this patio that we're sitting on. One of the really neat things is that there is an outdoor environment here, not just an indoor one. And of course, if you live in southern Arizona, as we do, you want to spend time outdoors. So there are some picnic tables, a fountain, and all this wonderful stuff to make people feel the hominess and the inclusiveness of this wonderful facility. So, Elizabeth, thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Ken.
Thank you for joining us on Walking on the Ween Side today. I hope seeing the wonderful work that's being done by a program like iWork has inspired you. If you live near a medical school or medical complex, you might want to share some of this program and the one from the preceding program with them and encourage them, because this is the kind of special program that really makes the world a better place. And, the funny thing for me, well, not so funny perhaps, but most meaningful thing for me was, is I listened to the volunteers and I interacted with people who came in for other reasons, into the artworks. Not the staff, not the clients, but other people. You could see how artworks was affecting them. And I have to add, it affected me, it affected my wife, who did an exhibit in their art gallery. It really is just a wonderful kind of program, part of making this world a better place. And truly, to me, it matters.